is Timothytrespas, and I'm a human being who has found himself targeted, given Morgellons. In this video, I'm making colloidal silver in water. And how is it done? Well, very simply. Small little bits of silver. 925-999 if you have it. A jar of water. Preferably distilled. Some alligator clips from Radio Shack. And some wire. And at the end of the wire there's a power supply from a printer, 28-volt power supply, and I simply cut the jack off and put the red wire to one wire and the black wire to another wire, and they go to the alligator clips and clipped on as the little bits of silver, and it sits in the water. As you can see, the alligator clips themselves are not in the water, just the little bits of silver on the end of the alligator clips. Why is that? Well, what we're doing is electrolysis, or electronic dissolution, electrical dissolution of element in the solvent water. And anything that you put in the water to transfer the electricity, the alligator clips, a piece of wire, will also dissolve into the water. As you can see, the water is filling slowly, ever so slowly, with this wondrous white cloud. And if you could actually see it on this other one, I don't know if you can. One of these is the anode, one of them is the cathode, and on one of them there's bubbles of hydrogen, I believe, as the water breaks down. Yes, you can just see the bubbles. As the water breaks down into its elements, little tiny bit of hydrogen and oxygen, I think, I'm not sure. Anyway, bubbles out, as you can see. On the other side, the anode, the cathode, whichever one it is, no bubbles, but what you do get is this wonderful white cloud of dissolved, or rather micro molecular silver. Tiny, tiny, tiny bits of silver. Why isn't it sparkly and silvery? Well, I guess that has to do with the size of the particle. As we know from nanotechnology, metamaterials, changing the size of a particle can sometimes change the way it interacts with light, restricting it to a smaller and smaller size will in fact change the color. You can make gold turn red, yellow, blue, orange, pink, black, white, gray, depending of course on how small you restrict the molecule, or atom of gold actually. Silver is an element, so it's an atomic thing, I believe, not molecular. I could be wrong, I don't know. Anyway, so what I'm going to do is sort of just let this sit here for quite some time until the water becomes so thick and cloudy with this silver that it's a very, 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 very high part per million. And then I'm going to use it to spray all over myself and around the room. This one I'm not going to drink, simply because the water I used had all kinds of little tiny, weird, floaty things in it, and I'm not sure what they are, but that's pretty much it. Fairly simple. Two wires, two alligator clips, two pieces of silver, a jar, some water, preferably distilled, a top, some holes in it, whatever, a piece of tape, some sticks, whatever you want to use to hold it on, so that the alligator clips don't go into the water. Just the little bits of silver. You can use silver wire, you can use silverware, you can use whatever, silver. Try to get the highest one you can. The 999 pieces seem to have disappeared, but that's okay. I'll work with what I have. And over several hours, this should get thicker and whiter and darker. And then it will be used for its antimicrobial, antifungal, anti-whatever properties. So, it's a power supply from a printer, 28 volts, plugged into AC, clip off the little adapter, strip the wires, one to one wire, one to another, one alligator clip on each side, one piece of silver, put it in the water, plug it in, make sure the alligator clips don't touch, and watch it dissolve. Thank you very much for watching. May God bless us all.